But right now, New York City's transportation officials have approved an extremely controversial ad that is scheduled to appear on New York City buses. Take a look. As you see here, the new ad shows a plane flying towards the World Trade Center engulfed in flames with the words, "Why there?" The reference is to a new mosque and Islamic center being built two blocks from Ground Zero. The city originally rejected the ad, but then approved it after the group behind the ad filed a lawsuit. Pamela Geller represents the group American Freedom Defense Initiative that is sponsoring this ad. She's also with the group Stop Islamization of America. I don't know. Is that a word?
It is a word.
It is a word.
1949.
Okay.
It's a word.
All right. Good. I'm learning something new here today.
And Pamela, I plan to show you a lot of things today.
It's good to have you with us because this is sparking a lot of controversy, especially here in New York City, because this ad really sparks a visceral emotion, a visceral reaction from people. Why do it?
Well, first of all, I don't understand why the ad is controversial.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't understand why the ad was rejected. I was told that 9/11 images were banned. Since when? Since when are 9/11 images banned? That's a piece of American history. Why is that controversial? To me, the premise is completely false. If you consider the image of 9/11 being America being attacked is controversial, but a 15-story mega mosque looking down on the burial ground of Ground Zero is not offensive? I don't get it.
But isn't that also part of American history? Freedom of religious expression.
Absolutely, but so is human compassion. And we're always being schooled and being sensitive.
But that's not so much in the Constitution.
Well, I'm not suggesting that the government stop the mosque. No, I'm not at all.
Mm-hmm.
I just find the callousness on behalf of Imam Rauf and Daisy Khan towards the grief and the outrage to the families and all Americans who were deeply affected by 9/11 to be radically intolerant.
We have a statement from the MTA, correct? Let's go ahead and take a look at this. While the MTA does not endorse the views expressed in this or other ads that appear on the transit system, the advertisement purchased by a group opposing a planned mosque near the World Trade Center was accepted yesterday after its review under MTA's advertising guidelines and governing legal standards. So, Pamela, how many buses is this going to appear on?
This is scheduled to appear on 20 buses. The original ad was submitted. I was told that 9/11 images were banned. I was told to remove the plane. I removed the plane. I resubmitted the ad. They told me to remove the smoke. I said, remove the smoke. Why should I remove the smoke? I removed the smoke. I sent it again. The towers against a blue sky with a tiny plane. They said, you have to remove the plane. Wait, it's just that you know, it's rejected four separate times. And then the last one was just the towers, and they never got back to me.
But that's it, though. That's the image right there that's going to be on buses.
Yes,
so
when
you
I
obviously
sued,
went
yeah,
back
when
to the
I
original.
Sued, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And, but that's not going to be how the mosque or Islamic Center looks over. I mean, it's not, the depiction there
well,
is not
at,
accurate.
That's the depiction that was submitted by the Imam and Daisy. That's the mosque, and it looks very dramatically like the World Trade Center. And if you look at the ad, it's September 11, 2001. That's
right.
What was happening. And then September 11, 2011, when the mega mosque is scheduled to open on September the 11th.
But that's not to scale. I just want to point out. Okay, so just from a personal history, I had family members that fought in Gettysburg. They died in the Battle of Gettysburg. There's a Baptist church right by the battlefield, and they were Southern soldiers. They were Baptists that killed my Presbyterian family members.
Are those images allowed? Are those images of Gettysburg allowed?
But what I'm saying is a church was allowed to be erected, a Baptist church, at Gettysburg. Also, there's a Shinto, the Japanese religion of Shinto. There's an American flag flying next to a Shinto shrine on the freeway to Pearl Harbor.
There's no Shinto shrine at Pearl Harbor. There's no Third Reich memorial.
I said on the highway, on the freeway
at
Auschwitz.
Look, I just feel that it's a human issue, that obviously this is created. If it was as the Imam originally said, which I find to be somewhat disingenuous, that it's about healing and that it's about building bridges, well, obviously it's had the opposite effect. So why not, in the interest of building bridges and healing, withdraw it? Even today, Governor Patterson said he would help them find another place. So this is not a small reaction. This is nationwide. And by the way, it's international as well.
Well, what's your recourse? Because I know that the commission that was that you were working with the landmarks they voted unanimously that the mosque could go forward,
right,
that the building did not have historic rights.
Well, that was really a dog and pony show. They had no power. They were all Bloomberg appointees. They were like Bloomberg's toolbox. But they also didn't know that one of the buildings was owned by Con Edison. They didn't know that. So that puts an obstacle in the road. Look, if it goes ahead, it goes ahead. But I would would be shocked. We held a rally June 6th with like 8,000 to 10,000 people. Mm-hmm. On September 11th, we're having another rally at 2 p.m. I tell you, the response has been overwhelming nationally. I'd be shocked if they would go ahead, despite the grief and the pain that they're causing, and just dismiss this kind of outrage and ignore it. When there's a hair trigger sensibility in the Muslim world, you can't run the Danish cartoons, you can't say Muhammad on Comedy Central. So where's the reciprocity? Where's the two-way
but
street?
But it's not in America. We're in America, Pamela. So we got to remember
you didn't
we're
run
America.
The Danish cartoons in America. MSNBC didn't run the Danish cartoons. And Comedy Central is in America. So it does work both ways here in America.
All right, I'm being told we got to go. But I could talk with you for a long time. Pamela Geller, thanks for coming
Thank
on today.
Thank you so
we
much for having
it.
Me.